Good morning, or whatever time of day it is that you're watching this, people. I am in rural, small-town USA, okay? I just want to show you some things to prove a point. There's a fireworks shop. Let's keep walking. There's an interesting flag. Several more, as you can see down the road. Here's another interesting flag. There's a flag. Here is another fireworks shop, same road. Here is the community center, which was used for a church function. It's where I used to go to youth group. Here's a church. I played and sang there on one occasion. USA flag along with the Indiana state flag. Here is the little park where they're going to have the festivities today. Looks like they're setting up, right? Coming up here on the church I grew up in, I actually helped build that ramp and paint it, and paint two sides of that building. Interesting van. Got another church here, right across from an elementary school. That's exactly where my dad would forget to pick me up. Crosses on a hill, classic. So basically the reason I'm making this video is to ask the question, where are all these people who are supposedly coming after people for like having flags up or going to church or any of those things, because I don't see it. And you might think, this is just because of where you are. But if you look at where the protests and things like that were happening, for BLM and all that, Portland, places like that, it wasn't the people flying American flags who were getting gassed. Just saying, just throwing that out there. Because we see a lot in the digital age, and I'll show you an example, what triggered this video, about how the least marginalized, or not marginalized at all, groups of people tend to play the victim. So I'm just out here showing you, how are you being victimized? Prove it. Like, for real. There's no fucking evidence for any of this stuff.